Okay, mate, let's talk about a few things specifically. 600 games, a lot of highlights, you know, a few championships thrown in there. Has there been one or two highlights that, you know, stick in your mind as being particularly memorable?
Yeah, I guess when you look back, I think I had a team in 2002 that had, it was an all-Australian team. And of course, the competition's changed and it's gotten a little bit better. But we had an all-Australian team and we had 9 out of 10 kids were Frankston kids. And we made the playoffs and we won a game in the playoffs. And I think that was a really big year for us. You know, it was terrific. And you got to have a lot of luck for that to happen. But that was really rewarding. And 2009 was similar. You know, we had, I think, 9 out of our 12 were Frankston kids. And, you know, that's something that the club has since I've been here, we've, as general manager, we've tried to sort of take that tack. You know, we used to spend a fair bit of money recruiting players from other associations, and we had success with that, you know. But there's always two definitions of success, at least. You know, and success in our case is to bring kids through and to see them develop as people and as players and be very competitive at the Siebel level.
Mate, I'll ask you this question now. I wanted to save it for later, but you're kind of talking about it there. Do you have a legacy that you want to leave on this club? I mean, how does Bill Runchie want to be remembered?
Nah, look, I think, you know, the club is always bigger than the people. Than any one person, indeed. I would like to think that during my time at the club, we've had some integrity about what we do. You know, and that's you know, in the junior level, we don't advocate zone defenses. We think it's better to develop kids with man-to-man, and we try to instill motion offense principles as much as possible. And we try not to recruit from other associations. You know, we think we do as good a job as anybody of developing their own kids. But if there's one thing that, you know, we do have a philosophy at the club, and I look involved on a Friday night with other junior clubs, I don't think they do have a philosophy, and I don't think they have a common terminology. And I think that's, you know, if I can leave that legacy along with the coaching group that we have, then I think it's easier for the coaches to take over to carry on.
As a coach, he's changed a lot. I think he's acknowledged that himself. He's grown as a coach, as in, I think in past days, his communication with players wasn't so great. And maybe he expected a lot out of guys, which is good as a coach, but maybe sometimes him not communicating back to them wasn't as great. But now he's just across the board with everything. In coaching, he's always supportive to his players, still demands a lot of them, but keeps the barrier between like the coaching and the playing sort of staff, which I personally find is good, because there's always sort of, you know, your boundaries. And as a coach in the change room, in growing as a coach, I feel that he does still have the joke with the players.
Mate, I'll also ask you a question. I've kind of asked you this before in the past, and you've mentioned names like David Gruber, maybe even Sean Redditch. Some of the best players that you've seen, you know, coached for or against, are there, you know, maybe two or three that come to mind?
Yeah. I think the reason they come to mind, like as you mentioned, David Gruber. I think Mike Kelly was one that I really admired. Those type of players are players that make players around them better, and I think that's the bottom line in any team. If you have a player that can do that, then he's just valuable. And Reese Newsome was another player that for us, you know, that made other players better.
Yeah.
Just doing little things like setting the correct screen at the correct angle and moving and separating from the screen, things that you try to teach kids now, but some of them twig and some of them don't. And Reese was just one of those kids that had a sort of an innate sense on how to play the game and took good shots all the time. So I think those players stand out. David Buehr was a player, I think, that probably made his teammates better. He was not the most skilled player, but skilled enough and played hard enough that he had a lot of championships under his belt because of it. So those are the people that I admire and have enjoyed watching playing over the years.